from dishes. So that when I tell them little things, please don't count my time. But when I talk little things, then you know the counting. I was telling the people back home that I will be talking tonight. Thank you for giving me this chance. Now I was thinking, what text or what example must I take to have a comparison for this boy from the Bible? I thought of Job, I thought of Abraham, I thought of Noah, I even went to Jesus, but whatever I tried seemed to fail. Then I've decided I will take a bird, the eagle. I want to compare this little boy, a friend and a peer indeed of my children.
Ek het gewonder wat ek moet gebruik as voorbeeld om Lisa van my gewigtig en kragtig te maak. En ek kon stop van aan die voel. Hy arend.
I'm calling him a friend of my kids because he started blowing the trumpet with my firstborn, and later on he ended up being a friend to the yellow beautiful girls you saw in the Ogada choir.
Ek noem hom my kind, want hy het met my seuns begin het trompet geblaas, en hy was ook 'n broer vir die geel meisies wat u in die Ogada choir.
I wanted to compare his faith, I said, with Abraham. I wanted to talk about Noah.
Ek wil sy geloof met Abraham vergelyk. Ek wil ook van Noah praat.
But I realized that age doesn't matter at all.
Maar ek het agtergekom dat ouderdom nie saak maak.
Age is a matter of mind, and if you don't mind, it doesn't matter.
Ouderdom is 'n ding of jy omgee of nie omgee nie.
I've met an old man in one of the foreign countries. He was joking every morning, and one morning I asked him how old he is.
Ek het baie groot manne in die verskillende lande ontmoet wat draf, en ek het op 'n môre 'n ou man gevra, "Hoe oud is
jy?" I asked him how old he
is. Ek het gevra, "Hoe oud is jy?"
Because he was joking every morning.
Omdat hy elke oggend gedraf.
You know what he told me?
En weet jy wat hy vir my gesê
het? He said, "Well, I'm still young."
Hy het vir my gesê ek is nog
jong. I'm 75.
Ek is net 75.
I thought, wow, come. Hoe die sikorons are. You must be joking.
Ek het gedink 71. 75. En nog jong, Chesa moet grappies maak.
I only take three characteristics of the eagle, but by doing so, I will read from 1 Corinthians 16. Verse 13.
Ek wil drie eienskappe van 'n arend vat. En om dit te doen, wil ek lees uit 1 Korintiërs.
It says, 16. Be watchful, be vigilant.
Wees wakker.
It says, stand firm in your faith.
Jy moet standvastig wees in die geloof.
It says, be a man, if you don't mind, be a woman.
Dat sê jy moet 'n vrou wees of jy moet 'n man wees.
And it says keep faith.
Maar dit sê in al hierdie jy moet die geloof behou.
African Methodist Episcopal Church, I congratulate you for having ordained such a young man.
Yeah. Ek wil die IME kerk geluk wens wat so 'n jong man.
Indeed, a boy with a deep ecumenical spirit.
A seun wat 'n baie
deep understanding of what it means to be one God, one baptism, and one faith.
A diepe geloof van een doop, een geloof.
Not just to be a bit fast, because my time will probably come towards one characteristic, the first one of the eagle is vision.
Die eerste ding van 'n arend, die eienskap van 'n arend is om wakker te wees.
It can see, it has vision. Kai moon oom. Sig
om sig te hê.
It has got good eyes. It can see far.
Dit goeie oor, dit kan vir
sien. And it can see the correct and the right things.
En dit kan die regte dinge sien.
That was this boy.
Dis wat hierdie seun van ons was.
Wherever I have listened to speakers throughout the past week.
Ek waar ook al ek na die sprekers vir die afgelope week geluister het.
The Spirit of God told me, hey Willem, this boy had vision in his life.
Die Gees van die Here het vir my gesê dat hierdie seun
'n visie het. He's going home by 36, but sometimes 86 old men are not doing such things either.
Of hy nog 36 was, 86 jarige ou manne doen nie dieselfde goed wat hy gedoen het.
You can be 90 years and still do childish things.
Jy kan 90 wees en nog kinderagtig wees.
You can be 90 years and we might end up wondering it or Obama Tisa.
Jy kan 90 wees en dan sal ons wonder, Opa, hoe is dit dan?
The reason why I wanted to talk tonight.
Die rede hoekom ek vanaand wil gepraat.
My leaders, members of clergy,
and die pastore.
I am really giving you a challenge to have vision.
Ek wil vandag vir u 'n uitdaging gee om 'n visie
vir die lewe te hê. For the African Methodist Episcopal
Church. Vir die IMEC.
Planning for what the church will say and do for gays and lesbians. And people of different sexual orientations in the next 5 years to come.
Om te beplan en te kyk wat die kerk sal doen met manne wat soos vrouens is en vrouens wat soos manne is.
People of different sexual orientation.
Mense met verskillende geslagsoriëntasies. Moet net nie dink aan wat kan gebeur nie.
The church, not only the African Methodist Church, the Church of God.
Die kerk as geheel, kerk van Christus,
nie die IMEC kerk. Start opening up its vision.
Moet hulle visie oopmaak
vir hierdie. Stop turning a blind eye.
Hou op om 'n blinde oog te staan.
To the real life and lifestyle.
To the young people. Die regte dinge van die lewe.
Not condone the wrong things they're doing.
Nie om dit af te keer nie.
But address and redirect what they're doing.
Maar om vir hulle rigting te gee in dit wat hulle doen.
Wat mamas kom op kan jy gou wat sy kas as in hier word.
Secondly, I was supposed to say
that. I will tell you more when we meet again. Speed.
Ek sou vir julle vertel dat as weer
sticks of an eagle is speed.
Die tweede eienskap van 'n arend is die spoed.
Hy sê sy sê dit jy sal kon kry.
Julle sing werk
en Johannes sê ons moet werk.
En Johannes sê ons moet
terwyl dit nog dag is.
Sê hy ja.
Alles kom die nag waar niemand kan werk.
So hoe kan hy presies en nog wel?
Do you see the short space of time that he lived in?
I'm seeing die kort tyd van sy lewe.
And I have at least heard, I don't know about you, the many things that he did in that short space of time.
Ek het ten minste gehoor alles wat hy in daardie kort tyd van sy lewe gedoen het.
Do what you do.
Doen wat jy doen.
Do it with vision.
Doen dit met
visie. Do it with the necessary speed.
Doen dit met die nodige
spoed.
Moenie staan en dink nie. Moenie te
kort wees nie.
Bly in die lewe skaap.
Dan mo ominga, kom ek uit daar kan sien. Kai,
rap bakker.
Have speed.
Jy moet spoed hê.
If you are young people,
as jy met jong mense,
and if they want the pastor to move,
and as
hulle wil move, and
as
jy wil move, if the young people want you to move,
as hulle wil hê ons moet loop,
move a bit.
Dan moet ons speed. Last things ek wil afsluit.
Accuracy. The apparent has got accuracy.
Om akkuraat te wees.
Do it.
Doen dit.
Correctly.
Doen dit reg.
Opkati. Ha. Kom dit hier.
Doen dit soos God dit sou gedoen het.
In your weakness.
En is swak.
And remember we folks, pastors are sinners.
En ons het gedink dat pastore is.
We are sinners, I'm saying.
Pastore is sondaars.
But remember,
maar onthou,
God uses other sinners to save other sinners.
Die Here gebruik so ander sondaars om ander sondaars te red.
Angels are not coming down from heaven.
Engele kom nie van die hemel af.
To call people to repentance, you remember what was said?
om vir die mense om tot bekering
te kom. Ons sê jy is die kaba kaba miba di mi. Solang die bin na ba kon na mtsotso.
Die mense wat al reeds daar is moet die woord van die bekering.
That pastor.
Daardie pastoor.
That man.
Daardie man.
That lady.
Daardie vrou.
You see as a sinner.
Wat jy as 'n
sondaar. Is called by God.
As van die Here
to save you.
Om vir dit
as 'n sinner.
I as a sondaar.
At another time that I don't see this.
I'll
talk more.
Pastor, what did you program?